Hey there, in this video I'm going to show you 12 tips for how to draw on blank paper starting right now. The number one tip I can give you is to pick the right motif. It's very important to pick the right motif because you want to maximize the use of the blank paper. Blank paper obviously is very suitable for dark settings or night scenes because the dark parts are already kind of just there already. And you just have to draw or paint the white or the illuminated parts on your characters or objects. Number two, pick the right paper size. Black paper is generally more rough than normal paper, so it can be hard to draw details on it. The larger the piece of paper though, the easier it becomes to draw these details. So don't make your life extra hard by choosing a small piece of paper if you want to draw lots of details. Tip number three is to choose the right medium. Normal pencils don't really work that well on black paper because there's just not enough contrast between the gray of the pencil and the black of the paper. Colored pencils, on the other hand, are a very good and popular choice. You could even go ahead and use just a white pencil and draw that on the black paper, which is kind of the opposite of drawing with a dark pencil on a bright surface, really. Here, the pencil is bright and the surface is dark. Number four, test colors before you start drawing. You have to understand that a lot of colors don't really work that well on black paper. They are too dark or appear darker than they actually are, and some colors can actually become nearly invisible on black paper. To get the colors you actually want, you should just test them out before you start your final drawing. Just keep a little piece of black paper around for testing like I do here. Tip number five is to use bright colors. Since black paper tones down the intensity of colored pencils a lot, it's recommended to use bright colors. They just tend to work a little bit better on black paper. Now, if you've gone ahead and drawn large parts of a drawing with a color that you feel is just too dark, you can always go ahead and try to brighten it with white. It doesn't always work out, but it can be used as kind of a last resort to save a drawing. By the way, if you found this helpful so far, consider subscribing to my channel where I post similar content like this. Tip number seven is don't use black or use black as an eraser. Many people actually recommend to use a black colored pencil kind of like an eraser, and it can work well for small areas of a drawing where you made little mistakes, but I would recommend you to use it with caution because what can happen is that the black of the colored pencil actually looks a bit darker than the paper itself, which can lead to some ugly little marks on your paper that in the end just distract your viewer from the actual image. So think about this twice before you do it. 8. Start light and build up your values. You see, with black paper you almost can't erase colored pencils. It's even hard on normal white paper, but with black paper it's kind of impossible. A way around this is to start using only light pressure and gradually press harder while rendering the forms. This way you don't really have to draw everything perfect from the start and get a bit of leeway, and you can actually finish your final drawing without pressuring yourself too much. Tip number 9 is to sharpen often. Colored pencils tend to get dull very quickly, and I feel like the rough black paper kind of amplifies this effect. So what I would do is just sharpen your pencil often. You can either use a handy little thing like I do here, or a normal sharpener like this. One way to get around this is to turn the pencil regularly. As soon as the colored pencil starts to get dull, just turn it a bit and you will see it has kind of this newfound edge, so that for a while it feels like it's sharpened again. This way you don't have to sharpen that often. Number 11 is to dust off your paper regularly. Don't forget to blow away the residue of the black paper every now and then, because if you don't do that, you can end up smearing it all around and leaving these ugly marks on your paper, which can actually be more prevalent than on white paper. And since you can hardly erase them, they might pose a problem, so just don't do that and dust off your paper regularly. And my final tip is avoid using a blending pencil. Based on my experience, a blending pencil doesn't really work that well on black paper. You kind of end up smearing around color without blending it effectively at all, and it can end up in a big mess really. So I wouldn't recommend you to do that. I really hope this video was of some use to you. Make sure to check out my other videos and also my blog, which are linked in the video description. Thank you very much for watching and see you next time.